The Redskins' playoff hopes hinge on these 17 events. The Washington Redskins beat the hapless New York Giants 20-10 on Thanksgiving Day. Not only did that stop the team from an embarrassing three-game losing streak, it kept their playoff hopes alive. Not only do the Redskins still have a chance at making the playoffs, they could be in control of their own destiny during the last 2 weeks of the season. Yes, you read that right. Now, it won't be easy, but after seeing Mr. 321's post on Reddit examining how the Cleveland Browns can make the playoffs despite a 0-10 start, I figured out how Washington can beat the odds and qualify for the postseason. At 29, Redskins QB Kirk Cousins dreams of ending his career on my terms. It all starts with the Redskins winning out the rest of the way, ending the season with a 10-6 record. Since 2002, the year the league expanded to 32 teams, 162 clubs have won 10 or more games, 152, 94%, of those made the playoffs. Washington will have to produce road victories over the Dallas Cowboys and Los Angeles Chargers in weeks 13 and 14, win at home against the Arizona Cardinals and Denver Broncos in weeks 15 and 16, and end its season with another victory over the Giants at MetLife Stadium. Using the same win probabilities that fuel our weekly power rankings, the most likely win is the game against the Denver Broncos, 73.1%. Who can't seem to get consistent quarterback play from Trevor Siemian, Brock Osweiler, or second-year pro Paxton Lynch, who left his debut Sunday due to injury. Overall, the Broncos are scoring 1.4 points per drive, the fifth lowest mark this season, while allowing 1.9, the 13th most. The hardest game remaining for Washington is against the Chargers, 34.5% win probability. According to the game charters at Pro Football Focus, the Chargers have the second-best pass rush in the NFL this season. Edge rushers Joey Bosa and Melvin Ingram have combined for 113 total sacks, hits and hurries in 2017, with 52 stops at or behind the line of scrimmage. Win those two games though and things take a very optimistic turn. But Washington needs help, too. A 10-6 record won't win them the division, putting them at the mercy of the wild card race, which, if the season ended today, would be won by the Carolina Panthers and Atlanta Falcons. So in addition to Washington winning out, they will need the Falcons, plus the Seattle Seahawks, Detroit Lions and Green Bay Packers to lose at least 7 games this season. Note, the Panthers can finish at 10-6 and would lose a tiebreaker to Washington based on conference winning percentage. Here's how that happens based on the most likely losses for each team over the remaining 5 weeks. Week 13, Baltimore Ravens defeat the Detroit Lions probability, 58%. Minnesota Vikings defeat the Atlanta Falcons probability, 61%. Philadelphia Eagles defeat the Seattle Seahawks probability, 71%. New Orleans Saints defeat the Carolina Panthers probability, 63%. Week 14, Minnesota Vikings defeat the Carolina Panthers probability, 55%. Tampa Bay Buccaneers defeat the Detroit Lions probability, 38%. New Orleans Saints defeat the Atlanta Falcons probability, 57%. Jacksonville Jaguars defeat the Seattle Seahawks probability, 64%. Week 15, Los Angeles Rams defeat the Seattle Seahawks probability, 57%. Tampa Bay Buccaneers defeat the Atlanta Falcons probability, 34%. Week 16, Minnesota Vikings defeat the Green Bay Packers probability, 75%. Week 17, Atlanta Falcons defeat the Carolina Panthers probability, 51%. If the above scenario happens, the Redskins would most likely finish as the first wild card team ahead of the 10-6 Carolina Panthers, due to the third conference tiebreaker, best win-loss tie percentage in conference games. If things play out in this fashion, Washington will have 7 wins over NFC teams while the Panthers would only have 6. Speaking of tiebreakers, for the purposes of this projection we didn't incorporate them beyond the final application between the Redskins and Panthers. With so much still in flux, it's virtually impossible to project all the permutations for some of the NFL's tiebreakers, like strength of victory and strength of schedule. but it is a little easier to calculate the first two conference tiebreakers, head-to-head victories and conference winning percentage. The biggest notes there as far as the Redskins are concerned is that they hold the head-to-head tiebreaker over the Seahawks and that winning out will give them 7 NFC victories. A 10-6 record by the Falcons would mean they'd have at least 9 conference wins, giving them the tiebreaker over the Redskins. The Lions need 4 wins to get to 10-6, but if their one loss is to an NFC team, they would tie the Redskins at 7 conference wins and proceed further down the